Hello friends, thanks for clicking and welcome to my channel. The definitions of common terms in stonework and brickwork are already given in the video on the stone masonry. The remaining definitions or technical terms pertaining specifically to the brickwork only are mentioned in this video. So let's start. First technical term is stretcher. As shown in this image, stretcher is a brick laid with its length parallel to the face or front or direction of a wall. A course containing stretchers is called a stretcher course. In this image, we can see these all courses contains stretchers. So this is known as stretcher course. Second term is header. As shown in this image, header is a brick laid with its breadth or width parallel to the face or front or direction of a wall. The course containing headers is called a header course. In this image, we can see these courses contains headers, so it is known as header course. Third term is arises. The edges formed by the intersection of plane surfaces of brick are called the arises. So in this image, we can see these are the edges formed by the intersection of plane surfaces of bricks. It is known as arises. These arises should be sharp, square and free from damage. Next term is bed. As shown in this image, the lower surface of the brick when laid flat is known as the bed. Fifth term is bed joint. The horizontal layer of mortar upon which the bricks are laid is known as a bed joint. So in this image, we can see this is the horizontal layer of mortar on which bricks are laid. So this horizontal layer of mortar is known as bed joint. Sixth term is perpends. The vertical joints separating the bricks in either length or cross directions are known as the perpends. So in this image, we can see this is the perpends, which is the vertical joints separating the bricks in either length or cross directions. For a good bond, the perpends in alternate courses should be vertically one above the other. Suppose this is the first course, this is second course and this is the third course. Alternate courses means first course and third course are the alternate courses. So, for good bond, the perpends in alternate courses should be vertically one above the other as shown in this image. Seventh term is lap. The horizontal distance between the vertical joints in successive courses is termed as a lap. As shown in this image, this is one of the course and this is the another course. So these are two successive courses. So the horizontal distance between the vertical joints in successive courses is known as lap. So this is the lap. For a good bond, lap should be 1/4 of the length of a good brick. Next term is closer. A piece of brick which is used to close up the bond at the end of brick courses is known as a closer. So in this image, we can see these are the closer which is used to close up the bond at the end of the brick courses. It helps in preventing the joints of successive courses to come in a vertical line. Generally, the closer is not specially molded, but it is prepared by the mason with the edge of the trowel. So here we will discuss the various types of closers like queen closer, king closer, bevelled closer, mitred closer in detail. So first type of closer is queen closer. Quoin closure is obtained by cutting the brick longitudinally in two equal parts. In this image, we can see this first image shows full brick, say, and if we cut this full brick longitudinally in two equal parts, then we get Quoin closure as shown in this second image. It can also be made from two quarter bricks known as the quarter closures to minimize the wastage of the brick. So, if we cut this Quoin closure again in two equal parts, we get Quoin closure quarter as shown in this third image. A Quoin closure is generally placed near the quoin header to obtain the necessary lap. So, in this image, these are the quoin header, and Quoin closure is generally placed near the quoin header to obtain the necessary lap. So, here you can see these are Quoin closure provided near the quoin header. Second type of closure is King closure. King closure is obtained by cutting a triangular portion of the brick as shown in this image. So, this triangular portion of the brick cut such that half a header and half a stretcher are obtained on the adjoining cut faces. A King closure is used near door and window opening to get satisfactory arrangement of the mortar joint. So, in this image you can see here there is provided King closure. Third type of closure is Bevelled closure. Bevelled closure is obtained by cutting a triangular portion of half the width but of full length as shown in this image. Here we can see this is the half part of header and this is the full part of stretcher. We get Bevelled closure. A Bevelled closure appears as a closure on one face and as a header at the other face. Bevelled closure is used for the splayed brickwork. Fourth type of closure is Mitred closure. Mitred closure is obtained by cutting a triangular portion of the brick through its width as shown in this image and making an angle of 45 degree to 60 degree with the length of the brick. Mitred closure is used at corners, junctions, etc. Next term is bat. Bat is a piece of brick usually considered in relation to the length of a brick and accordingly known as half bat or three quarter bat. So, in this image we can see this is the first one is half bat, second one is three quarter bat and this last one is bevelled bat. Next term is bullnose. Bullnose, a brick molded with a rounded angle as shown in this image, it is known as bullnose and it is used for a rounded quoin. So, in this image we can see this is the double bullnose and this is the single bullnose. A connection which is formed when a wall takes a turn is known as a quoin. So, in this image we can see these are the quoin. So, bullnose are provided as a quoin. The center of the curve portion as shown in this image is situated on the long center line of the brick. Next term is Cownose. A brick molded with a double bullnose on end as shown in this image is known as Cownose. So, in this wall there is provided Cownose. Next term is Squint Quoin. A brick which is cut or molded such that an angle other than a right angle is formed in plan as shown in this image is known as Squint Quoin. Next term is frog. A frog is a mark of depth about 10 mm to 20 mm which is placed on the face of a brick to form a key for holding the mortar. So this is the frog, and depth of this frog it should be in between 10 to 20 mm. The wire cut bricks are not provided with frogs. A press bricks as a rule has frogs on both the faces. A handmade brick has only one frog. So in this image, this first image shows the press bricks and second image shows the handmade brick. Next term is racking back. The termination of a wall in a straight fashion is known as the racking back. So in this image we can see this is the termination of a wall in a stepped fashion, and it is known as racking back. And last term is toothing. The termination of a wall as shown in this image. So termination of the wall in such a fashion that each alternate course at the end projects is known as toothing. Toothing is adopted to provide adequate bond when the wall is continued horizontally at a later stage. So thanks for watching. I hope this video will be helpful for you. For more updates, subscribe my channel and don't forget to share this video with your friends.